Assalamu alaikum, welcome to Cooking is Fun with Firdaus. And today we will be seeing how to make mutton mandi. Here we will make our own mandi masala. So it will be quite easy for you to, you know, make it at home rather than looking out for the store-bought masala. Let's begin. Here I'll be using 1 kg of mutton. And for this 1 kg of mutton, I'll be using around 3 cups of basmati rice, which I have already soaked. To begin with masala, we'll be adding 1 teaspoon of red chilli powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and 1 teaspoon of black peppercorn powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, and salt as per taste, along with 1 star anise and 3 cardamom, 2 cloves, ginger powder about 1/2 teaspoon, and 1 1/2 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste. Now let's mix all these ingredients together well until they are nicely mixed together with the mutton, and marinate this for about 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, in a double boiler or a steamer which has holes in it so that the broth gets collected below. So a double boiler is required with the holes like this. And we will be adding about 5 cups of water below, because as it will reduce, we will get approximate of 3 cups of water for the rice to be cooked. Here we'll place the mutton pieces above and let this cook for about 10 minutes on high flame and 60 minutes in low flame until the meat is well and tendered. Also below we'll get all the broth collected. Since I'm using 5 cups, I'll be getting around 3 cups of broth. So after 60 minutes I checked on my meat, it looks very tendered and delicious too. After this I checked on the water. As I told you, 3 cups of water has been collected, the broth has been collected. Always measure your broth because it's very important. So the remaining 3 cups, I'll be adding the plain water while cooking the rice. So let's begin cooking in the rice. Here in a large thick pan, I'll be adding about 2 to 3 teaspoons of ghee. You can also add oil, it's up to you. And 1 bay leaf along with cinnamon and 1 large onion chopped. To this onion, I'll be adding the same mandi masala which I have been using to marinate the mutton. It's just 1/2 teaspoon of each ingredient, like 1/2 of each ingredient which I was using to marinate the mutton. And the same masala, I'm adding it to the onion. And once the onions are translucent, I'll add green chilies and 1 teaspoon of tomato. This is actually my way of cooking. If you want, you can skip adding this tomato and green chili, but I like to add. Next, I'll be adding in the broth. As I told you, 3 cups of broth and 3 cups of normal water for my 3 cups of basmati rice. I'll be adding salt as per taste and let the water come to a boil. Once it comes to boil, I'll add the rice along with the coriander leaves. And let this cook in a medium flame for about 20 to 25 minutes or until the rice is done. Meanwhile, what I'll do is I'll take the mutton in a baking tray or a grill tray and I'll just try to brush it up with some oil, drizzle some oil and brush it with some red chili powder which is dipped mixed with some lemon juice and some salt. And I'll just brush all my mutton nicely and ensure that each piece is coated well with this chili mixture. And I'll grill this for about 30 minutes on a high temperature. And on the other side, what I'm doing is I'm just getting my charcoal ready because I want a nice burnt-y charcoal flavor to my mandi. Now let me check if my rice is almost done, the water is completely evaporated, the rice is getting soaked. I'll place a steel bowl along with a teaspoon of ghee and place the charcoal, burnt charcoal in it and close the lid. Also close that nozzle with the clove, okay, and let this completely evaporate and let the rice completely soak in that steam and get a nice charcoal flavor. Do not try to be quick in this part. It'll take like about 45 minutes at least. After this, check on your rice. It's cooked. What I'm doing is I'm going to add the grilled mutton to it and give it a nice mix. After this, we can serve delicious mandi along with the tomato salsa and some chopped onions and some lemon. So guys, hope you like this recipe. If you try this recipe, please do share your comments below. And thank you. Stay tuned with Cooking is Fun with Firdaus. Still lot more to come. Allah Hafiz.